morning. Today, Chris Moyles arrived at this London studio. He's put his favourite DJ and self-proclaimed saviour of Radio 1.
I'm the saviour.
Hello. Hello,
darling.
He can present his own breakfast show with his eyes closed.
It's a lot smaller in real life.
I wish I could say the same, Chris.
Hosting his own late-night entertainment show. Let's find out.
Patronising bastards.
Because now it's time for... Justin Lee Collins, Alan Carr, our band tonight, The Twang. But here he is, please give a big welcome to our host, it's Chris Moyles.
It's going to be a good show tonight. It's been a very busy week. Big news is Tony Blair travelled to Germany for the G8 summit. I don't know if you know what this is all about. It's all the big topics of the day. It's the new Cold War. It's global warming. It's Africa. But surely he's forgetting the biggest issue of all.
I can't help it if I've got a natural curl to my head. That's too short.
Leslie, she has been having a miserable time all week. I noticed she didn't exactly put her heart and soul into that hide and seek challenge. England won the football on Wednesday. All right. Well, you're right to clap, but let's not get carried away. It's only Estonia. I mean, footballers are not going to get an easier chance to score than that. On second thoughts. Ladies and gentlemen, let's get on with the rest of the show. Are you ready? Please welcome my house band for the night. It's the brilliant The Twang! We have the saviour of Radio 1 here with us tonight. Now, you got that job and you made that very bold claim. You said, I'll be the saviour of Radio 1.
I did, yeah.
Now, I take it was a little bit... It was tongue-in-cheek when you said it at the time.
Yeah, the secret is I've been using that saviour line at about three radio stations before that. It's just that, you know, not many people know about Radio Dunstable, so... I just kept it when I went to Radio 1 and it worked.
But it's actually turned out to be true because you're completely thrashing all the competition, aren't you?
Yeah.
So 8 million listeners now?
You know, I don't want to go on about it, but yes, Justin, thanks for...
What time do you have to get up in the morning?
I meant to get up about 5:15, 5:05,
oh,
but I...
No.
I don't, as a rule. As long as I'm there by 7 o'clock, then, you know, it's kind of all right. So some mornings I get in at 7:03 to go, good morning! Yeah.
But the great thing is, you finish work, you're watching Jeremy Kyle. And when he says, get a job, you're like, I have one.
You're known for being a big fan of Big Brother.
Yeah, I like it, yeah.
Haven't you spent one or two nights actually in the Big Brother house?
I've stayed the night in the Big Brother house.
Was that this year, last year?
Yeah, last year, yeah.
What was that like?
It's the weirdest thing. And so you walk into the bedroom and you go, wow, you just say, you feel you should talk. So you're on your own going, beds. In the bedroom. There you go, check out the toilets.
Don't you get confused with all the different Big Brothers? Do you do? I don't, you know, you don't know. What was the one where Vanessa Feltz went mad and stuck that bottle up her badge? Which one was that? What one was that? Was that the second one? Here, you know who I'm addicted to? Watching that Leslie, have you seen Leslie on the live one of E4 when you're watching her? I cannot take my eyes off her. Have you seen her? She's like...
She's brilliant.
Honestly, she's like a lizard. You think like a Mrs. Tiger?
Chris, what about Emily? Emily has been booted out of the house, the Bristol girl, the first time a Bristolian has ever been in that house. She's lasted 2 days. She's booted out.
What do you think of the pink... What's the pink-haired cleaner called? What's she...
Tracy the Reeve.
Yeah, but do you hear that story? Allegedly, she smuggled, didn't she, acid in a tampon? Yeah. Can you imagine that is... Can you imagine being stuck in the house and having, like, a tripping fanny? That must be... That must be awful. Oh, no wonder her hair's gone pink. That made me feel funny when I read that. That's disgusting.
Chris, Al and I were quite lucky earlier this week because we got the chance to come down to Radio 1 and see the master at work.
Yes, it was a very interesting morning. The boys came to see me at Radio 1. Take a look.
Hello, you lovely man.
How are you?
Oh, I'm so tired, Chris.
Right, where are your eyes?
What, they're behind these glasses. Yeah. This is ridiculously early for me.
It's all right, it's not too early.
Ow, morning. Ow.
Hello.
Hello. I'm going to get a semi.
Chris, anything you want today, mate, we're here to help you.
OK. We're on in a minute. We're going to news and then we're on. International
Radio 1. Howdy, partners. Welcome along. It's 2 minutes past seven. It's Monday. It's the 4th of June.
For those of you just waking up, I know it's very early, Justin Lee Collins and Alan Carr today are helping out the show behind the scenes.
Hi, Justin.
All right, Chris, how you doing, mate?
Hi, Alan.
Hello.
Hello.
It's Alan Carr, everybody! Look! Look, Alan Carr!
I don't sound like Zippy.
Yes, you do.
Do you want to play the first record?
Yes, please.
Okay. That's the start button there.
Just do that one there?
Yeah.
Okay.
You ready?
Yeah.
Here we go.
Now. Is it good?
Yeah.
Bruno Brooks is shitting himself.
Do you need any jobs you need them to do, Dominic? Anything you need the boys to do?
You could do the weather for us.
I've got a tragic story I want to say.
Oh.
Do. How did it go?
We can do it. Put your headphones on.
Oh.
Ready? OK.
I was touched up on a night, but...
OK.
We'll save it for later.
It's tragic.
Yeah,
it is tragic.
I'm doing sports. Hang on, Justin Collins has said, well, you had to sort out with Carrie. She's very, you know, you'll have to wrestle for it.
Carrie, I'll wrestle you for the sport.
Okay.
Bring the noise, Carrie.
Bring it on. Well, Justin's obviously scared, so I'm doing the sport. Andrew Flintoff won't play for England again until the end of the summer, the earliest. He had a third operation in 3 years on his left ankle on Friday.
Frankie Dettori had a hell of a weekend after his derby with Epsom on Saturday. He fell about the victory in the French derby yesterday. Go on, Frankie.
You're so rude. I'm still going.
All forms of cricket, because it would be wrong to build people's hopes up. Let's just see how we go.
And the French Craig Pickering's on his
I'll let you share a little bit of an insight to the show. This is our computer. All the text.
I read that first text.
This is the best show you've done all year. Been in fits of laughter all morning.
Oh, how lovely.
Equally, though, on the same page, this is Car Crash Radio, one absolute pile of stinking garbage.
Oh, thanks, man.
No.
Let's play some music so you can get on with your day. We started off 3 years ago and since... Anything else you'd like us to do, Chris?
Yeah, piss off.
OK.
Oh.
Yeah. Alan,
thanks.
Pleasure. Love meeting you. Justin, thank you.
Oh, really big fan.
Oh, thank you.
All right, and all that.
Yeah. Thanks,
no worries. See you later.
See you Friday. Thanks,
bye.
Guys.
Bye.
See you Friday.
Bye.
Cheers,
bye.
Dave.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Bunch of...
It was so lovely.
Oh, I had such a laugh.
Wouldn't it be great to be famous DJs like Chris? Don't you want to dance? Do you want to dance? Don't you want to dance?
Uh-huh.
That was Whitney Houston. Now it's time to slow things down with the erection section.
Not yellow. This is
isn't what I had in mind. I wanted to be hosting a Radio 1 breakfast show, not spinning the wheels of steel at some rubbish wedding do.
Never mind, Justin, it's not all bad. Look. I think the bride fancies you.
She is gorgeous. But it's your wedding day. Ow, I can. Can I? Thanks, Christine. That was amazing. But how did you manage to give your new husband the slip?
I think he ran off with your DJ friend.
Quiet, Mr. Groom. I've been waiting for this moment all night. Time for you to experience my extended 12-inch. Not like that, you pervert!